We have vascular diseases that compromise our body.
Some of those examples include stroke, hypertension, diabetes, and sickle cell disease.
And I like to think that the technology that I'm working on has the ability to help doctors intervene quicker, which means that we're able to use MRI, EEG, and near-infrared spectroscopy together to understand how vascular diseases impact the brain. In short, the way that I like to look at it is I get to play with magnets, lasers, and sensors to be able to interpret what's happening to our brain when it's healthy and also when something goes wrong. For a very long time, we assumed that neurotechnology did not work well on people with certain hair types, whether it's long or curly, as well as people with darker skin tones. And so my lab is working on and making sure that we have inclusive neurotechnology as well as who we're collaborating with. A lot of the creative and innovative work, specifically with certain disease models, rare diseases, is not as well funded. And so the challenge is that in the US, it looks like it's not as much of an issue, but it's a world problem. And I think we should invest to be on the forefront of innovating such technology. And I really think that it'll make a difference in health disparity and health equity and some of the challenges that we see, not just when it comes to race, but socioeconomic status and how accessible our technologies are. So often we are trained to be segmented in how we do things. So if you're interested in diversity, equity, inclusion, you can do it through outreach. You can take care of the kids, but why does that not mean that you cannot innovate through that same lens? So my lab takes that focus specifically at neurotechnology and ways that we assess how the body functions and the brain functions. But in addition, we're also doing a good work. We're doing a hard work, and we want to make sure that it doesn't matter what you look like to be a part of the team. It's a matter of what's in your heart.